in the sport of wrestling, we have seen heinous acts. Referee Alan Maloney forced Andrew Johnson to cut his hair or be disqualified. Johnson would go on to win his match. Maloney would continue to face suspension to this day. When Daryl Debo Mason of Minnesota State faced the number 3 ranked wrestler in the country, Sean Streck of Central Oklahoma, and came out victorious, Streck took his anger out on his opponent, pushing him, throwing equipment in his direction, and giving an awkward handshake.
So his son was wrestling in the high school match when the opponent picked him up, slammed into the mat. The ref did call the move illegal, but that's when the father runs in, tackles the wrestler. He's been charged with simple assault and disorderly conduct.
Watch the ref's reaction when it happened. Watch the ref.
And
he's like, wait. Yeah, he's like, oh, what was that?
In the state of North Carolina, one parent of an athlete, Barry Lee Jones, tackled his kids' competitor on the mat in a shocking video. In the sport, parents show how emotions can get the best of them.
Aaron Brooks, Penn State.
Yet what occurred at the collegiate level with Penn State's Aaron Brooks was completely uncalled for.
I want God to use me, but how am I being pulled back into like loving the world?
Because you see, he would preach loving all on his YouTube channel, but when he won his 3rd straight title in the post-match interview with ESPN, Brooks, a devout Christian, said, "Christ's resurrection is everything. Not just his life, but his death and resurrection. You can only get that through him, the Holy Spirit only through him. No false prophets, no Muhammad, or no anyone else. Only Jesus Christ himself. I'm blessed. God used me. He gave me this platform for this right here. It's all for his glory."
And we're all special in our own ways, and God put us all together. It brings the best out of each other.
Where was this mindset after winning? Why put down other religions? Ariel Helwani would write, "What a strange and disrespectful thing to say. Pretty darn weird. Not to mention offensive to Muslims. Also can't believe they put the clip and posted it on Twitter." The latter was in reference to ESPN and the NCAA, who pulled the clip.
"You know, we repent. I said pictures like, people say, you flush in the toilet. You know, that's the best way to put it. Flush in the toilet. Is new again."
Friend of the show Dave Zirin would write, "Disgusting. But he can say what he wants. Why is the NCAA promoting this anti-Muslim rhetoric? What a bankrupt nonprofit." The Philadelphia chapter of Council on American-Islamic Relations would admonish Brooks for his statement, but leave the door open for growth from one human being to another. "We commend athletes who use interviews as an opportunity to thank God for their success," the group said in a statement, "but it was both unnecessary and inappropriate for Aaron Brooks to randomly denigrate Islam while representing Penn State and its diverse student body on a national stage." The group encouraged Brooks to meet with his Muslim classmates at Penn State to build bridges, exchange perspectives on religion, and learn how to respectfully disagree. Penn State and Aaron Brooks alike refuse to respond to requests for comment. What I will say is this: you can thank whoever you want when you have won, or even when you have come in second place. To go to this length is inexcusable. And it requires a follow-up from Brooks, because this should not happen. Umar Lee, a reporter and writer with Bloody Elbow, addressed what he witnessed at the event. "I confronted Brooks after the tournament and asked him why he had to put down Muslims in order to promote his faith. His response was that all religions and prophets are false, other than those of Christianity. Jesus is the only way," he said. Noted, that's his theological opinion. "But this choice to target Muslims while standing just a few feet away from Muslim ban architect Donald Trump shouldn't be viewed as coincidental." You read that correctly from Mr. Lee. The twice impeached pro-insurrection president attended the college wrestling championships in Tulsa, Oklahoma, shook plenty of hands, and conducted photo ops. No politics in sports or whatever rings true. Unless, of course, it's their way and only their way. What viewers on ESPN were unable to see is that the NCAA championships were essentially turned into a Trump rally, Lee wrote. Winners were guided to greet Trump and take photos with him in between matches, which prompted an assortment of pro-Trump chants and cheers.